Hello, I'm Archana. Welcome to another lesson on skillActz. Imagine this. You and your friend attend a party together. Later, you speak to other friends about it. Strangely, both of you give a different account of the same party. You found the hostess fun and friendly, whereas your friend found her loud and annoying. You both had a different version of the people, the food, the games. You both experienced the same situation differently. This happens all the time. Why is it that everyone's version of things and places is sometimes slightly and sometimes vastly different from the others? The sensory information we receive is the same, but we interpret it differently. So, perception is when sensory data comes in through filters to give us a unique understanding of situations and people around us. Let us understand a few key factors that influence perception and then move on to the barriers that impact it. The first factor is attitude. When you have a positive attitude towards something, you perceive it differently from someone who has a negative attitude towards it. So let's say you enjoy the outdoors. So a holiday in the hills, which involves trekking and adventure, will really appeal to you. Whereas the same holiday will be rejected by somebody who does not like physical activity. The second factor is mood. Let's say you are in a bad mood and a visitor comes into office. Your mood will have a strong influence on the way you perceive that person. You may remember him negatively for no fault of his. The third factor is motivation. Unsatisfied needs exert a strong influence on us and make us perceive the world differently. For someone without a job, even a job in a small organization may appear as exciting and may be welcomed, whereas the same job will not be appealing to somebody who already is employed. The fourth is expectation. If you ask a mother what she sees in her child and a neighbor what she sees in the same child, you'll be surprised and you'll think that they are talking about two different people. The mother sees a fun and a friendly child, whereas the neighbor sees a child who's loud and causes disturbance with all the running and shouting. Finally, self-concept impacts perception. For a person with a positive self-concept, a difficult situation will appear as challenging, affording her an opportunity to use her abilities in that situation. Whereas, for someone with a negative self-concept, the same situation will appear threatening and they may want to run away or turn away from that. Apply these factors to a few situations in your life. You will come to understand how you are playing a significant role in the way you perceive your world. Doesn't that make you more accepting of individual differences then? Another aspect of perception is perceptual accuracy. We do not perceive reality quite accurately because of the shortcuts that we employ while perceiving. I'll discuss three shortcuts here. The first is selective perception. This is our tendency to perceive only certain sensory inputs from our environment. The result is a partial and often incorrect version of reality, which will be different from others. Imagine how nice it would be if the boss and the subordinate saw the same situation in the same way. The second is stereotyping. We tend to stereotype people, situations, etc. to make it easy for us to deal with the world. Man, woman, middle class, upper class, an American, an Italian. We label and classify just about everything. These classifications mislead us into imagining commonalities that don't exist. Not only are apples different from oranges, but each orange is different from the other orange. And finally, we'll discuss the halo effect. This can be best understood by an example of celebrities. we see them as successful and attractive, and further attribute qualities such as intelligence, kindness, and smartness into them, which they may not possess. This is caused by the halo effect. There's a tip here to use this flaw in perception to your advantage. Be well-groomed. It makes people attribute many positive qualities to you. However, be careful to ensure that you do possess certain of those qualities so that you can create a lasting impression on the other person. There are many other factors that distort perception. In this lesson, we have discussed three so that you understand that there are faults in our perceptual process. We see the world not as it is, but as we are. Did you like this video? Do let us know in the comments below. Please like and share the video and subscribe to our channel so that you continue to get new videos from us. Thank you and bye for now.